CSS isn't just about styling websites. It's a powerful tool for crafting amazing animation effects, especially fitting for the festive season. In this video, we will create a snowfall effect as a fun project that shows how CSS can transform static web pages into something engaging. Using CSS gradients, custom properties, and animations, we will design realistic-looking snowflakes that drift gracefully down the screen. This is Optimistic Web, where we explore the world of CSS and front-end development, one step at a time. Let's start by setting the stage. We will begin with a simple HTML page that includes just a page title. In the CSS, the body element will feature a cool backdrop of a snowy night. I'm using this high-quality image from unsplash.com to set the mood. The image is center-aligned, has a fixed attachment, and is set to cover the container. Add a minimum height to ensure the background spans the entire viewport. To further enhance its look and feel, we can add a layer of linear gradient on top of the image. And then, the background blend mode will throw its magic to transform the image into a masterpiece. Now we can use CSS Grid to position the page title right in the middle of the viewport. The Place Content property serves as a shorthand to align content both vertically and horizontally in one go. And after adding some typography styles, the page looks clean and polished. Moving on, we will add a div element with the class Snowfall. This will act as a single source of snowflakes for today's effect. It will be a positioned element, with the inset property set to 0 to cover the screen. Since it uses absolute positioning, its parent element needs to have a relative positioning context. Next, there are different ways to add snowflakes. We can either use multiple HTML elements, use an SVG, or leverage the power of gradients. Each method has its pros and cons. For this project, we will use CSS radial gradients to generate multiple snowflakes from a single HTML element. With this CSS rule, we are creating one instance of snowflake, which will be placed at 5% from the left side and 10% from the top. The first color stop is at 3 pixels, and then the second color begins right after, which is transparent. If we preview the page now, we will see a white dot. Currently, it has solid edges, which doesn't look natural. We can change the second color stop to a larger value than the first to make it look more realistic. Next, we can add another layer of a similar gradient to create the second snowflake. This time, the size is slightly smaller, and the position shifts to 65% from the left and 28% from the top. Now we have two snowflakes on the screen. While we could add as many layers of gradients as we need, having too many animations on a single page can negatively impact the performance. To achieve a natural snowfall effect without overloading the page, we can use the background size property. By reducing the horizontal area, we allow CSS to repeat the gradient layers along the x-axis. Like in this case, setting the background width to 65% triggers the background repeat property to replicate the same pattern horizontally across the screen. Additionally, the before and after pseudo elements can be used to multiply the number of snowflakes without needing to add new gradient layers. And by applying the same background size technique with a random width, we can generate even more copies of the snowflakes. To create a natural placement, we can adjust the inset property on the pseudo elements to update their vertical positions. And then adding opacity variations will further enhance the visual appeal. Now it's time to add movement to the snowflakes. Since they aren't individual HTML elements, we can't simply adjust their position. These are all background layers with fixed horizontal and vertical positions within the gradient map. So the vertical positioning of 10% for the first layer and 28% for the second layer should be dynamic. In such cases, we can utilize the at property rule to register a custom property and then use the same to create animations with greater flexibility. In this example, the property name is Y, which is restricted to accept percentage values, and the initial value is set to -1%. Now we can replace the hard-coded vertical positioning with the newly defined variable. To introduce another layer of randomness, we will multiply the variable by different multipliers for each background layer. This will create variations in their animation speeds. Next, we will define a keyframes block to update the variable in a smooth CSS animation sequence. Then, we will add the animation property with the desired duration, iteration count, and timing function. The same will apply to pseudo elements, but with different animation durations to add variety. To enhance the effect further, we will introduce another animation layer for a wind effect. This will simulate the horizontal movement of snowflakes, making them sway slightly as if blown by the wind. This additional layer can be added to the same animation property we used earlier. Finally, to ensure a seamless user experience, we can set pointer events to none for the snowfall element. It will prevent any accidental interaction issues and keep the focus on the content. And that's how we can use CSS custom properties, CSS gradients, and a bit of creativity to achieve a beautiful snowfall effect using only a single element. However, when using multiple animations on a page, especially with complex effects, it's important to be mindful of performance. Too many animations running simultaneously can slow down the page and lead to janky animations. We've also created a short video showcasing the multi-element approach, so be sure to check it out for an alternative method. If you learned something new today, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more front-end development tips and tricks. Feel free to leave your questions or comments below. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.